Dear all, welcome and thank you for tuning in. I am Dr. Luwai ALZUBE, and I'm creating a series of videos that are going to be serving as aptitude biomedical engineering tests with answers for you. Through these videos, you'll be able to check your knowledge about biomedical engineering. In this video, the first one, I'm going to be talking about what is biomedical engineering. So the first question is, what is the primary goal of biomedical engineering college courses? This is a very important question. You need to understand what are you learning and why are you learning the topics that you're learning. So is it to study the history of medicine, or is it to explore the applications of science and mathematics to improve human health, or is it to learn surgical techniques, or is it to analyze medical ethics? And if your answer was to explore the applications of science and mathematics to improve human health, this is a correct one. So going to the next question that you need to ask yourself, what is the purpose of PET, which is positron emission tomography scans? This is from medical imaging. So if you look at the answers that we have, the four answers, and if you check which one is the correct one, and you landed on number three, to observe the biochemistry of tissues and organs, that is actually what is happening, because the positron emission tomography is an imaging modality that is focusing on the functionality inside the body, not the structure of the body. Going to the next question, what is the function of a heart-lung machine during surgery? So is it to monitor the patient's vital signs? Is it to replace the functions of the patient's heart and lung? Is it to administer anesthesia, or is it to perform surgical incisions? If you selected the second choice, which is to replace the functions of the patient's heart and lung, that is correct. Now, the fourth question, what does an electrocardiograph, ECG or EKG, measure? Is it the blood flow? Is it the bone density? Is it the electrical potential of the body surface? Or is it the chemical reactions in the brain? If you selected the third one, electrical potential of the body surface, that is correct, because it's measuring biopotentials. Now, the fifth one is, what is the process of growing cells outside the body called? And if you look at the four options we have, and you selected the third one, which is cell culture technology, you are correct. Now, the sixth question, what is the purpose of a gene chip? And if you look at the options, is it to create artificial organs, or is it to identify expressed genes in a sample, or is it to develop a new surgical tool, or is it to analyze bone structures? And if you select it to identify expressed genes in a sample, that is correct, because you need to see which genes are upregulated and which genes are downregulated at a specific condition. The seventh question, why are airplanes important in organ transplantation? And how is this related to biomedical engineering? And if you select the second option, they transport organ quickly to donors. From donors to recipient. This is a very important application of biomedical engineering in healthcare. Now, the eighth question, what is a key property of materials used in contact lenses? This is a big breakthrough when it comes to vision and the healthcare and the health of the eye. So if you look at the four options, and if you selected the third one, that's inertness, that is, it does not interact or do any chemical reactions with the surrounding tissue, and safety for eye contact, that is what we are looking for. The ninth question, what is the primary function of an artificial hip? And if you look at the four options, I'll give you a minute to see what are they. And if you selected the second one, to replace a diseased joint and restore mobility, that is actually what it is. This is very important because a lot of biomedical engineers are actually interested in biomedical engineering because of prosthetics and the design of artificial limbs. Now, for the 10th question, what distinguishes engineering from science? This is a very important question that you need to understand and be able to answer. And if you look at the four options, and if you selected the third one, which is that engineers primarily design and build things, new things especially, while scientists observe and describe and they do discovery. So for engineering, engineers do design and development, and scientists do discovery and observations. The 11th question, what is a key characteristic of engineering? And that's important to understand what engineering is actually. And if you look at the four options and you've selected the second one, designing and applying science to create useful things, that is engineering. And this is the reason why I got actually into engineering, because I like to build and rebuild and design new things. The 12th question, when did engineering become a recognized discipline at universities? You'll be surprised that it wasn't that far ago in history that we have engineering as a discipline. And if you selected mid-1800s, you are correct. The 13th question, who received the first PhD degree in engineering at Yale? Yale is one of the leading academic institutions in the world, you know, when it comes to engineering. So the first one who got a PhD degree in engineering was J. Willard Gibbs. Now, the 14th question, what was a significant factor in the dramatic increase in human health expectancy during the 20th century? You know, before the 20th century, people were dying for a lot of reasons, and there was a big breakthrough that took place that allowed humans to live for a longer lives. And if you selected the control of infectious diseases through antibiotics and vaccines, you're correct. What was a primary cause of death in London in 1665? So this was before actually the breakthrough that we had in the 20th century. And if you selected infectious diseases, you're correct. What is the role of biomedical engineers in relation to scientific discoveries like penicillin? And penicillin was one of the most important actual discoveries that helped humans control infectious diseases. And if your answer was scaling up production and making them widely available and affordable, you're correct. So engineers, we do not get involved into the chemistry or the biochemistry of things, but when it comes to manufacturing and production, that's where engineering and biomedical engineering comes in. Now, the 17th question, what are the current leading causes of death in the US? And we have four options. And if your answer was heart disease and cancer, you're correct. The 18th question, what is the purpose of the weekly lab meeting in a biomedical engineering course? So I'm teaching biomedical engineering courses, and I'm inviting you to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so that you get notified when I upload a new biomedical engineering lecture from the courses that I'm teaching. But if it comes to the lab, which I'm going to be creating more videos about the lab in the near future. So what is the purpose of having the lab? If you look at the options here, and if you selected to conduct hands-on laboratory work, you're correct. And we're going to do a lot of these in the coming videos. So please subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. And if you have gained any value so far from this video, please give us a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family or anyone who you feel that they can benefit from the video. And you can leave us any questions in the comment section. We'll be more than happy to reply to you and answer your questions. Now, the 19th question, what are the three main components of the final grade of a typical biomedical engineering course? The one, something that, you know, similar to what I'm teaching. And if you look at these options, there are different types of format of the grading. But if your selection was a midterm exam and a final exam and a project and a laboratory component or work, you're correct. That's how I teach biomedical engineering. So if you're interested, please subscribe to the channel and stay tuned for more videos. The last question, what analog can be used to describe the current state of biomedical engineering? Biomedical engineering is still an evolving discipline, and it is changing quickly with time. And if you look at the options here, and if you can think of an analogy to what this current state is, and you picked constructing a bridge that is still being developed, you're correct. It's still evolving, and it's still a playground for engineers all around the world. I hope this video was helpful. Please, if you found any value in this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and to hit the notification bell. Thanks for watching, and till the next video. Bye.